So don't lose heart, don't you dare let go. There where you are not alone. I know it gets dark, I know it gets hard, but we're gonna make it home. So don't lose heart.
Yo, 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 Pastor Jace here, how are you? How were the last 3 weeks? Yes, I just came back from the mission trip to Asia. Where? I visited Cambodia, Philippines, and Korea. Thank you for all of your prayers. And I'm okay. I also want to say thanks and hi to all the missionaries in Asia. Pastor Ronnie, Pastor Chung, Pastor Wu, Elder Pang, and Elder Jang. I am here safe and sound. I was happy to see all of you. Physically, I'm worn out. But I'm excited to make a plan for the next year mission trip. We must do more mission projects while we can. That's right. You know what? It was like yesterday when we had the New Year's service, right? It is already February. Unbelievable. Is your New Year's resolution still valid? If you are, you are doing a great job. If you're not, don't give up. You can start again. You can do it. When you plan, don't make a big plan. Listen to me very carefully. I will tell you how to make a successful resolution. Draw a big picture of your goal and at the same time, make another small goal you can easily carry out. Just like a small water drop makes a big current eventually. Make a small step first. Just tiny step. One by one. And you will get there at some point. Don't try to read through the entire Bible. Most likely, you will quit. If you don't think Old Testament is too hard to read, start from the New Testament. If you think it's too hard, start with the Gospel of John or the Gospel of Mark. At least one chapter or one page. The first step is very important. Today, I would like to talk about love. Oh, no, not the kind of love you think about. Of course, about God's love. Because the thing that touched me while I was visiting Asia was love. I realized anew that mission is love, not ordinary love, Christ's love. So I want us to examine the meaning of love through today's text. Let's read 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 through 9. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. Amen. One of the most heartwarming and touching words in 1 John is today's text. We all need love. Love is the most essential element in our life. Love brings courage to those who are discouraged. Love gives healing power to those who are struggling. Love provides comfort. If there are things we must keep precious in Christian life, it is faith and love. Because of this love, missionaries go on missions, and the seed of the gospel is sown. The Apostle John calls his fellow Christian as dear friends. He's urging that let's love one another. That's right, let's love one another. The text explains three reasons why we have to love. First, because of love belongs to God. Just as light shines from the sun, so love comes from the very essence of God. So God's children must love one another. The second reason is that we were born of God. Just as we were born and live with our parents' DNA, we must not forget that those who are born of God have God's character and DNA. Yes, we have love of DNA. That's why we must love. The third is that we know about God because we are born of God. It goes beyond knowing fact about God. When we know that God is love, we cannot help but love. I met many missionary families in Cambodia. I respect each and every one of them. Without God's love, how could they work in such a barren land? From the 80-year-old president of the National Institute of Technology and his wife, and to the family of Pastor Jung Ji-eung, who planted the church 11 years ago and has come to this day. The hard work of each and every missionary can only be expressed by God's love. When we think of missions, we think that missions are going to remote places and bringing things and fixing houses and coming back after hard labor. No. Mission is providing God's love and love every individual soul. We will quickly learn that we only need God's love in mission field. In mission field, we learn more and we are challenged more than we can give to them. When there is God's love, mission is possible. We can love every soul. Second, we have to love one another because God's love. Let's read chapter 4, verse 9. This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him. The purpose of God sending His only Son, Jesus, was, of course, to save us. We were spiritually dead because of our transgression and sins. But we are alive. Yes, we are alive again through Jesus Christ. God gave us the hope of heaven. God gave us salvation. What hit me the most during this mission trip was Dream City in Korea. I was very uncomfortable to have Sunday worship service with the homeless. I wore two overlapping masks to prevent infection. And I attended service nervously, as if they all carry germs. Dream City's worship is not what we think it is. Dream City's worship services do not have a choir or a grand piano, only Pastor Wu's guitar accompaniment and a volunteer's keyboard. Whoever the person who praises becomes the praise leader. So everyone is a choir, everyone is soloist, everyone is praise leader. Neither the beat nor the note match. Praise continues until no one comes out to praise. The praise they chose seemed to be imbued with pain and tears and the scars of life. However, there was comfort and hope for each other in praise. Particularly one person came out and praised the title, The Mission, and made me burst into tears. Let's listen to this music.
Through the mountains, all the raging seas, to the ends of the world I go in peace, giving all of me to the lost and hurt. I will gladly my heart, my life.
I was so ashamed of myself to wear two masks because I was afraid of getting infected. I was prejudiced. I was cautious not to be closer to them. I was wrong. It was tears of repentance. I was thinking, what did I do to deserve a warm house, a comfortable bed, and loving family? What makes I am better than them? Boy, I cried and cried. There are people who come out every day to serve, and there are pastors who and staffs who almost live together with them every single day. I was so ashamed. Even though it's close to 2 hours worship service, no one left from the worship service. They had a hope. They had dreams. God was there with them. They praised God despite of their circumstance. Jesus has been preached. God's love was preached. Because of God's love, we must love one another. This love is a love for salvation. The missionaries we sponsor are 5 missionaries in 3 countries in Asia. Besides them, I met 6 more missionary families. I placed our love into a bottle of vitamins you brought. They were comforted, encouraged just by my visit. Let's watch together.
안녕하세요. 캄보디아 정지웅 조은영 선교사입니다.
How are you? I am 정지웅 and 조은영. How was your New Year? We had a great gift of the Holy Spirit by Pastor Kim, and he preached to our church, and also he provided officer training, and I was really overwhelmed. Most of all, I thank you for your gift, your love, your blessing, and we got all the power. Thank you, and I love you. Philippine 방호영 장로님입니다. Thank you for visiting me and thank you for prayers. And I will just live with our best with thankfulness. I'm grateful for your prayers and support. Philippine 장재중 장로님입니다. It's been a long time, even though I'm in a far place. I feel and you are with us. And I'm praying for your church to become more passionate church for foreign mission. It's a dream city, Uyunshik pastor. And thank you for sending Pastor Kim, and thank you for your support, thank you for your prayers, and stay healthy, and I hope I can just come to see you, visit you. Thank you. People of God are people who have God's love. People who have God's love are the people who know how to share. Let's love while we can. Let's share God's love while we can. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us Jesus Christ. You showed your love. You gave us unconditional love. Father, let us have courage to share your love. And we just realize that that's a true love when we share your love to one another. Father, thank you for blessing. Thank you for giving us wonderful family, wonderful house. Father, we are blessed by you. Let us remember who are less fortunate than us. And let us pray. Let us pray for the countries who is going through a tough time and hard time. And use us as a tool to deliver your message to them. We thank you. We are grateful. Now I'm asking your abundant blessing in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Spirit to every one of us here, as well as our family, our churches and our countries, all the people going through a tough time and a hard time. Please be with them and all the medical staff taking care of the patients now, and all the missionaries and ministers spreading your word throughout the world, all the American soldiers fighting for peace and freedom throughout the countries. Bring them home safely. Amen.